that we have so often taken in the past. Whenever a single person addresses an issue, it can spark change. Whenever a group addresses an issue, it can create change. But so often, people ignore the issues or challenges that they see. That is merely using the life we've been given in a way unbefitting of that gift. Because we have that opportunity to face issues and to strive for change, or to face the challenges that we will and get through them, if we don't face them head on and rather sit back and let someone else take the charge, then we are wasting the gift we've been given called life. So, since I won't see many of you again, and I won't ever get to see and talk to any of you again, I'd like to give you one challenge as we go out here. My challenge is that we reject the passivity that is so easily succumbed to whenever we're faced with a difficulty. My challenge is that we take an active role in facing the problem that we're facing. And my challenge is that you will take responsibility for the actions that you have and for the reactions that you take in response to the things that life will come up to you with.
Good evening, faculty, families, and graduating class of 2018. My name is T.A. Anderson, and tonight I stand before you astounded that this day has finally come. We've each struggled in our own way to make it here tonight, but the fact that you're here, graduating from high school, shows that you've persevered and won. But where do we go from here? High school has instilled in us all the necessary tools to accomplish anything we put our minds to, but it needs some direction to put it all to good use. Nothing is stopping you from becoming the person that you want to be, except yourself. Every day, we get up and make a choice. These choices, however minuscule they may seem in the moment, are charted the rest of your life. But regardless of where your personal experience has led you up until this point, you can make a switch at any time to go after what you want. If you're heading straight to work, be the best worker you can. If you're going to college, work hard and push through. Going into the military, become the ultimate soldier. Even if you're sitting on your mom's couch, be the best couch sitter there ever was. Whatever it is, go after it to the best of your ability and you will find success. So I want each of you to ask yourself, what is it that you want? Stop saying, I can't, I won't, I might, I'll try, maybe later, and start searching for what you're truly passionate about. Like the late Steve Jobs said, the only way to do great work is to love what you do. If you haven't found it yet, keep looking. Don't settle. Thank you.
From the kids in Ms. Charton's kindergarten class. Number one, listen to your your parents even though you're like 42. Number two, don't go faster than a cheetah because that's against the rules. Number three, go catch bad guys. Number four, my mom made a grasshopper. Number five, get out there and do some work. Number six, write like a scientist. Number seven, don't cut down your neighbor's tree. Number eight, just go to class. Number nine, if you hear a train horn and you're on train tracks, you better get off. Number 10, don't say bad words because it will make your mama sad. Number 11, get an A+. Number 12, my personal favorite, remember that 10 plus 10 plus 10 plus 10 plus 10 equals 50. Number 13, give all of your toys to kindergartners. Number 14, when you go to the bathroom, don't leave the door open. Number 15, don't be mean because you will go to jail. Number 16, get money. Number 17, be smart because you're a good listener. And finally, number 18, I don't know, I don't like questions. So to take some advice from my new friends with Sequoia, don't use bad words, don't be mean, don't go faster than a cheetah, don't leave the bathroom door open, but do get an A+, get a job, get money, get bad guys, write like a scientist, and maybe eat the occasional grasshopper. Because not every day is going to go exactly as planned. That's just life. You have to embrace the fact that you have absolutely no idea what you're getting into each day. Sometimes things change or plans fall apart. You just got to roll with the punches and make the best of it. There will always be more to do, more to experience, and more to learn. So get out there and do some work. Do some great work. Do some excellent work. Do something worth talking about. Something that will make your parents proud and your teachers proud. Be the type of person that doesn't just settle for mediocrity. Do things that others aren't willing to do, because nothing exceptional will ever occur from being just like everybody else. So no matter if you're here at Tech next year, or if you're in Texas next year, or in LA, or in the workforce, at John Brown, or in the Naval Academy, at OU, UCA, U of A, wherever you go, be unstoppable, have some fun, accept challenges, take your work seriously, but don't ever take yourself too seriously. Thank you. The choir members will sing A Million Dreams.